you're just joining us, the Grand Prix final is the final event of the Grand Prix series. Elvis Stoico was to have skated here. He received a medical bye because it's been such a long season, especially on that groin injury that he's had to come back from. So he's not here, nor is Takeshi Honda. But Alexander Abt is fourth after the short program.
I think Elvis also felt that it would just be too much to do three competitions within a month. He needed the recovery time after Four Continents. But Abt is also recovering from a knee surgery, which he had early in December. What he was able to do in the short program. He's opening with a triple axel. Goes down. Because of the knee surgery, he wasn't able to compete at Russian Nationals, therefore not able to compete for a spot on the world team. He's going into his quad here. 2 foot there.
Just another example, perhaps even the poster boy, for how deep men's skating is in Russia. We hardly see him on the circuit during the year. And now look, he's in the Grand Prix final.
He's never made it to the World Championship. Him, I'd be, I think, looking at moving countries.
Several skaters have done that.
And his first clean jump there, a triple lutz. Shaky landing on that triple flip there. He's looking tired.
That was an interesting entry into the
jump. I know. See him take that big, deep breath. This program went over really well last season. However, this it doesn't seem to have the same impact. He's skating through a lot of the little nuances.
was a struggle for Alexander Afton. You could probably attribute that to the injury. He just hasn't been able to put too many miles on in the rink, only 6 weeks, 7 weeks after knee surgery. We'll be back.
He could do the quad. He could fly, that guy. We'll have that game tomorrow. Alexander Abt had problems flying at St. Petersburg tonight.
Here's the quad. Doesn't get the rotation. He landed that actually forward. He's lucky he stood on his feet. And he missed both his triple axel attempts. He gets great height, but can't hang on to that landing.
Had meniscus surgery on his left knee. Late December. Presentation marks. Alexander Abt, the leader, and the man who was behind him in fifth place after the short program is on the ice. This is recently crowned American champion Michael Weiss. So an opportunity for Michael to leap ahead of Abt.
He won his first U.S. national title a few weeks ago with a rather lackluster performance. I'm sure he's looking for a performance here which will boost the confidence going into Worlds. He's going to open with the quad toe. He has never landed it cleanly in competition, although he's been very close. That looks pretty good. We'll have to wait for the replay.
He fell on the quad in his attempt in the short program. He was docked after that. Maybe he has his first clean one.
Getting to the soundtrack. Combination for him right here. The triple axel, triple toe. Oh, he flips out of the triple toe. He doesn't have a great deal of speed for that second jump. Costume rule states that
U.S. men's champion Michael Weiss.
He started out strong with the quad toe, but couldn't follow it up.
When we come back, we'll take a look at that quad toe. Did he land it? Sure what it is. WWW dot something. But he describes himself as the last U.S. men's champion of the 20th century. Could he add a quad?
That looks good.
That really looked good.
Let's see it again here.
I think he
might have towed.
And I think he did tow. He is so close.
So close, so often. But I have to say, I'm not often a costume critique, but that jacket drove me crazy.
Technical merit marks are strong. Presentation marks will put him in first place ahead of Alexander Abt with the three Russians remaining. But Michael Weiss following in Todd Eldridge's wake. Eldridge, a world champion, a silver medalist a year ago. Todd Eldridge never landed a quad. Never needed it either. Michael Weiss is very close. Maybe it'll happen for him in Helsinki at the Worlds. So now the battle between the Russians, the three of them. One skated already, Alexander Abt. Here is the teenager, the Russian men's champion, second at the Europeans, Evgeny Plushenko. Second after the short program.
And he opens with the most difficult combination in skating, the quad triple.
Dressing room, does he? Goes for it.
He doesn't like to miss, that's for sure.
He'll have to be clean for the rest of this program.
Second triple axel here. He needs this one. Same mistake as the first. Hand down. He's not getting the run out of the jump that he usually has.
Thank you. He had the Bielman spin at the end. But a very rare night. Evgeny Plushenko doesn't have the jumps. So on this season, making progress week to week, event to event. And I'm wondering if this Russian teenage machine may be starting to sputter at the most inopportune time, only weeks before the World Championships.
That was the first attempt at the quad. Here's the second attempt. 2 foots it there. Hangs on to get the double toe on the back end. But he had to fight for every jump. And that is so unusual for him because usually he just does them so effortlessly. I think the fact that he started changing the program around forced him to really be thinking on his feet all the time, and the choreography got lost.
Maybe thinking ahead to his next item that he had on the agenda and just forgot about what he was doing at the time.
And certainly he's a contender for the gold medal at the World Championships, but didn't look like it out here at all.
His coach, also the coach of Alexei Urmanov, Alexei Mishin. They all trained here in St. Petersburg. Alexei Yagudin left Mishin and went on after winning the Worlds.
It's not as easy as it was last year. There's a lot more pressure, a lot more on the line.
He underwent a huge growth spurt as well. His body's changing on him. Still a very talented skater, though, and someone you know will be a contender at the Worlds.
And the 5'8"s there are way too high, considering what he didn't do.
The leader ahead of Michael Weiss. Two more guys to come. Plushenko knows he must skate better than that in Helsinki, however.
A bit of breathing room here.
And you know the heat's on in this building, too. Alexei Yagudin and Evgeny Plushenko may have been training mates, but I don't think they share a fondness for each other, as we saw in Minneapolis last spring when Yagudin celebrated Plushenko's misfortune. Yagudin's the world champion, the leader, after the short program.
He's won everything this year except for his Russian nationals, where Plushenko beat him. He also beat him at one other event, so there's quite a rivalry that has built this season. He'll open with the triple axel combination. Triple toe.
Russian flags out for the world champion, Alexei Yagodin, a couple of weeks away from his 19th birthday. The veteran is next. Alexei Yagodin.
He opens with a spectacular combination here. Good height on both jumps. And here's a look at his quad. Good height. He just can't quite check out of it. But he hangs on to the 1 foot landing.
A lot of pressure in the building tonight here at the Russian Nationals. I mean, ISU Grand Prix. All these Russian skaters, high marks, despite the popped axle. Presentation marks high, so they keep him up there. It's going to be tough for Urmanov to get anything better than that. And Yagodin was far from perfect. Plushenko congratulating him. And so the final men's skater. And this must be like deja vu all over again for these guys. They did this only a few weeks ago at the Russian Nationals. Alexei Urmanov, the Olympic champion in 94.
He was the very first Champion Series final champion in 1996. He won this event.
He was third after the short program. You look at those marks. He's going to have to be absolutely perfect in order to win this thing.
But he certainly has a great shot at silver. There's always a question mark with Alexei whether or not he will do the quad. Doesn't have a really consistent quad, hasn't landed in a competition for a while. So he will either open with a triple flip or a quad toe. What's he gonna go for? It's the flip.
Schmeichel finish? We might see another one in St. Petersburg at the end of this.
To skate in Europeans than here. Yeah, it was hard here because all my friends are here in these tribunes and they watched me. So, but I was ready to win here. I don't know why, but I was completely ready to skate good, and so I did great.
How did this set you up going into Worlds? Did it give you a lot of confidence?
Yeah, you know, it was, as for me, it was like a break between Europeans and Worlds. It's like a preparation before the Worlds, so I skated good, and so now I'm for sure I'm ready to be number one again in the world. So it just helps me.
You seem to be having a lot of fun out there. The quad, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, I feel really good, but I wanted to make quad tall, triple tall, but you know, sometimes happens and you never know what you will do, how you will end. So next time, I hope.
Next time, I will. See you there. Thank you.
And not only will he have that guy to meet, but also a guy named Elvis and the rest of the world.